अखंडम सच्चिदानंदम अवान मनस गोचरम आत्मानम अखिलाधारम आश्रये भीष्ट सिद्धये। On the last Wednesday, we saw a lot of preliminaries about the Prakarana Grantha, most important Prakarana Grantha of Vedanta. Sadananda Yati is Vedanta Sar, and also studied the first three mantras. And we found that this Prakarana Grantha deals mainly from the Prameya Mimamsa, that means the nature of the thing to be known. The nature of the thing to be realized is Brahman. The nature of the thing to be realized is the identity between individual soul and the universal soul. And from the nature of this Brahman, everything else is derived. That is the particularity, if you like to call it, of this great Prakarana Grantha, which is universally taken as the best primer of Vedanta. And another thing we found, that it is free from the Nayayika technology, technical terms too much used in the other books published after the 14th century. It is entirely free from that Nayayika terminology. Very simple, straight, and it presents Vedanta in the form of definitions. And the definitions are so crisp that they can be universally used anywhere. And the definitions have been arranged in such a way that we arrived at the Prameya Mimamsa. And then, when we started studying, generally we should understand that these Vedanti people, they never waste their time in any formality. So, Mangalacharan is not a Mangalacharan. He has declared the very nature of the reality in the first shloka, comparatively. We are all Satchidanandas, but Khandita Satchidanandas. We have to think of the Akhanda Satchidananda. And this Akhanda Satchidananda is beyond mind and vani. So he has declared it to be Nirguna in its nature, Sarvatita. And yet it is myself, yet it is the support of all. That is Sarvatita Sarvagata. Sarvatita Sarvapi is the nature of the reality he has declared. And another thing he has declared is that identity between the individual and the universal. It is Atmanam, means it is the reality of every individual. And side by side, it is the substratum of the entire world. So individual and the entire world are the same reality. So that is how it has been described. And then he says that we have to take resort to this only. If we want our desire to be fulfilled, desire is nothing short of realization of God. There is no other desire. And such a desire, to fulfill such a desire, we must take resort to the nature of the reality. We, by individual effort, it's difficult to reach that reality. But if we use the very nature of the reality as the way to reach it, we can surely reach it. That is the first shloka. And the second shloka, he has another important point. He has told us that the absolute necessity of Guru in this endeavor, because our mind works in Maya, it may distort the truth. That is what we generally find. Those who independently, some people independently want to study Vedanta and they come to grief. So the absolute necessity of the teacher is declared in the Shlokan Shloka. And the teacher should be a person of realization. So that he tells by Arthato Api Advaya Ananda. Atita Dvaita Bhanata. Because his bodha, his bhana, his awareness has gone beyond all dualism. So he is the real guru. And worshipping such a guru, even to tell others about that Vedanta, it requires the grace of such a guru. And with that grace, he is explaining the essence of Vedanta. Not beating about the bush, he will go straight to Vedanta, and the essence he will tell us, Yathamati means as he can express it, as it he has assimilated it. And with this, we read the... Some disturbance has come? Okay. Now, in the third sentence, another important feature he has told. What is Vedanta? He started defining now. What is Vedanta? And there also we have seen that Vedanta is taken in two different senses. One thing is that it is the best among the schools of philosophy. And I tell you, I salute these Vedantis or this Vedanta from a long distance. Our purpose is to realize God, not to enter a system of thought. A great philosopher, Dr. Mahendranath Sarkar of the Calcutta University, giving the annual lecture in the Nagpur Ashram, I told, we may get a perfect system, but the truth will escape us. We may get a perfect system, but the truth will escape us. We are after the truth. We are not after any system. So, the other meaning of Vedanta has to be accepted. And which is the real meaning? The end of Vedas is Vedanta. And so we saw last time, Vedas means super sensuous knowledge. Though literally Vedas means all knowledge, but actually Vedas means super sensuous knowledge. And this super sensuous knowledge we find consists of three main factors. One is the Devata Jnan, finding consciousness in the matter or energy, universal, particularized. Agni Devata, Varuna Devata, Indra Devata, Vrksha Devata, Vana Devata, etc. This is Rishi's vision, transcendental vision. This is the first type of supersensuous knowledge. The second type is to find the absolute laws between karma and karma fal. If you do such karma, you will get such result. This is uncannily, absolutely told by the rishis by their supersensuous knowledge. And the third supersensuous knowledge is the knowledge of the subtler supersensuous entities. This gross world is made of subtle matters combining, then only it becomes gross. Parallel example from science is the protons, electrons, neutrons and whatnot. But we do not see them in science. But here, it is proposed, not only proposed, but the yogis and the rishis see the subtler elements and see the mind in the subtler elements and see our indriyas, our mind, and finally, they realize the Atman itself. And so, this is another type of super sensuous knowledge included in the word Veda. Now, when this reaches its culmination, and the culmination is that they realize the reality is one without a second, existence, consciousness, bliss is the approximate description of it because it is beyond all description. So, then the jump takes place in our consciousness. Devatas there, we are demanding something. But if there is only one consciousness, my consciousness cannot remain separate from it. First jump. Secondly, nothing called matter can remain. If Brahman is one without a second, if Brahman is Sarvatita and Sarvavyapi, if Brahman itself is appearing through infinite names and forms, only because we are not aware of the consciousness, we see only names and forms, and that we call jada. So actually, when the Brahman is realized, neither I am separate, nor anything in the world is separate. Everything is Brahman. This is the meaning of the word Vedanta, the culmination of Vedic knowledge. Sanandaiti defines this Vedanta Nama Upanishad Pramanam. There we found the important thing last time. He does not say Vedantas are the Upanishads. Upanishads can be used in hundreds of ways to get PhDs. Upanishad Pramanam. When Upanishad is used as a means to get that knowledge, then only it is called Vedanta. Vedanta Nama Upanishad Pramanam. Upanishads used as means of knowledge of that Brahman is called Vedanta. And it does not limit it there. Tat upakarini shariraka sutradini cha. So that which helps it, like the shariraka mimansa sutras composed by Bhagavan Badarayana Vyas, in which he has not put logic, but he has put logically, that means in a way which is easily comprehensible, systematically comprehensible, all Upanishadic sentences he has put. Shankar's famous sentence is there. Vedanta Vakya Kusuma Grathanam Hi Sutranam. Sutra means the thread. Thread is used to make the different sentences of Vedanta into a garland. That is what Vyasadeva has done. So that is very useful in the study of Upanishads. And Adi, that means we know that Bhagavad Gita is the divine commentary on Upanishads. So that is another important scripture. And also, Shankaracharya's books, Ganeshwara's book, Sri Ramakrishna Leela Prasanga, and other books by and on Sri Ramakrishna and his disciples, they are all helpful to understand Vedanta, to assimilate Vedanta, to realize Vedanta. So that he has added in Sharirika Sutra Adi Nicha. The Sharirika Sutras are called Vedanta Sutras, Brahma Sutras, Vyasa Sutras by us. Now, we come to the, that is what we studied in the last Wednesday. We come to the fourth sentence now. Asya Vedanta Prakarnatvat Tadiyaihi Eva Anubandaihi Tadvatta Siddhehe Nate Prithak Alochaniya. It is important whenever we take hold of any spiritual scripture to study Anubandhas first. We thought of these Anubandhas on the last occasion. The prayojan, the purpose for which we are studying them. Who is studying them? What is his fitness? What is the subject matter? And how to study that subject matter to get at that desired result? These four are called Anubandhas in any spiritual science. They can be put in very simple English terms for ready reckoning. Adhikari will say who or for whom. Who is studying or for whom is the study? Vishaya will say what we are studying. The subject matter means what we are studying. We should know it beforehand. Sambandha means how we are studying that. So, who or for whom, what, how, and prayojan means what for. For what are we studying? So, if you remember these four simple words, who, what, how, what for. Then we remember all the anubandhas. Now here Sadandayati is telling, Asya means this treatise which he is proposing, Vedanta Sar, Vedanta Prakarana Tvat. Tvat is Panchami, Hetu of Panchami. That means because it is a Prakarana of Vedanta, Tadiyehe Anubandhaihe, Tadiye means belonging to Vedanta. Eva, same thing, only Anubandhaihe, the four Anubandhas which are for Vedanta, Tadvatta Siddhehe. Let us understand this word, Tadvatta. Vidvatta. One who possesses Vidya is called Vidvatta, Vidwan. So, in Hindi, it is a beautiful expression. We say wala, topi wala, dud wala. So, tad wala, vah wala. Kya wala? Jo Vedanta ka anubandha hai, vahi wala. Ye tadvatta ka arth hoga. Tadvatta siddhe hai. Automatically it is established that because it is Vedanta prakaran, so the anubandhas of Vedanta itself will be a Vedanta for this Vedanta sar. Nate prithak alochaniya. So we do not have to discuss separately what are the anubandhas of Vedanta sar. Does not mean we don't have to discuss them. What he wants to tell us that we don't want to discuss separately what are the anubandhas of Vedanta sar, because the same anubandhas for Vedanta will apply here also. That is the Tadvatta Siddhaye. So, being possessed of those very qualities, that is Tadvatta. Because it is the Prakarana Grantha of Vedanta, showing one side of Vedanta, then whatever are the Anubandhas of Vedanta will apply here also. We need not separately discuss what are the Anubandhas of Vedanta, sir. So now it comes, what are the Anubandhas of Vedanta? That is how it proceeds. They must be discussed every time, but not some separate thing, don't imagine, for this book. Same Vedanta Anubandhas will apply here also. So now he enumerates the Anubandhas. Tatra Anubandho Nama Adhikari Vishaya Sambandha Prayojanani. Tatra means in that respect. In what respect? The Anubandhas of Vedanta. Anubandho Nama. What are the Anubandhas? So here he only names them. What are the four? Generally in English it is translated as prerequisites. Prerequisites, middle requisites, past requisites, permanent requisites. When we study the spiritual scriptures, these four things must be always awakened in our mind. So, Anubandha Nama, he has named the same thing which we have just now told, Adhikari, the fit recipient, Vishaya, the subject matter, Sambandha, the connection between the subject matter and the thing to be realized. Prayojanani, plural, four are combined. So, Prayojana means the purpose for which we are studying them. Now, he takes up one by one. That is his method. Adhikari, he tries to define. In this respect, let me tell you a little funny something. Not very funny. The professional training center was started in Belurmat. Exactly here I will not be able to tell, something around 1956 or so. And Swami Bodhatmananji, he was called Bhava Maharaj, was the first principal. And we had the fortune to study under him. And he His favorite was this Adhikari. He used to teach us Vedanta, and any brahmachari, anywhere in the street in Belur Math, if he meets, he would say, tell me the definition of Adhikari. That is the funny incident. So, that is the funny incident I wanted to tell you. The meaning is that it is very important. Now, this you have to study a little carefully. We can divide it into two parts. The process and the desired result. Who is the Adhikari? Such and such. How he becomes such and such? These two things are combined here. And so, we have every right. If we can arrive at the same result through some other process, it will become equally valid. I will read, then you will understand. Adhikari tu. Tu means but. I have told you the names. But what is the meaning of tu here? Adhikari is not anything external. That is the meaning of tu. Adhikari is not that sannyasi is adhikari, grasa is not adhikari. Adhikari is not that Brahmins are adhikari and others are not adhikari. Adhikari does not mean Hindus are adhikari or Indians are adhikari, others are not adhikari. Adhikari does not mean Purushas are adhikari and Stris are not adhikari. So, tu means remove all these external ideas from the word adhikar. Adhikar is something mental readiness, fitness. So, adhikari tu. Vidivat adhita veda vedangatvena apatato adhigata akhila vedartha. Point by point. Asmin janmani janmantareva kamya nishitta varjana purasaram nitya naimittika prayashitta upasana anushtanena nirgata nikila kalmashataya nitanta nirmala swanta sadhana chatushtaya sampanna pramata. We make a short sentence and then add others. Adhikari to pramata. That is the main sentence. We have seen that pramana means the means of correct knowledge. Prama is the correct knowledge. Prama is that reality which we want to know. Pramata is one who can realize. Pramata is one who is as if measuring Brahman. Pramata is one who can know Brahma. So, who is Adhikari? Who is Pramata? That is the main sentence. Adhikari to Pramata. What is Adhikari? No external consideration, but one who has the fitness to know Brahma. Now, what are the factors of fitness and how they are attained? So, step by step we go. Vidivat Adhita Veda Vedangatvena. Nowadays, very few people read Vedas or Vedangas. Does it mean they are not adhikaris? Two ways we'll approach it. We'll broaden the meaning of this from the modern point of view. And secondly, we see the desired result. And the desired result is apatato adhigata akhila vedartha. So, methodically, Vedas and Vedangas. Vedas are four. Vedangas means there are six such sciences which help us to understand Vedas. They are called Vedangas. Now, if we have methodically studied Vedas and Vedangas, then let us see from the result point of view. Result of methodically studying. We'll take two examples. One is of the great Shankaracharya himself. He was a genius. At the age of 5, he was sent to Vedic school, and by the age of 8, he had finished his studies. Correctly, methodically. Now, two possible results were there. He was born in Kaladi, he studied there in Kerala. And the various kings in Kerala, he started inviting him to be the Sabha Pandit. That would be the outside result. But that was not the expected result by the Vedantis. The expected result was that he knows that the Brahman is real. He knows that the world is unreal, but he wants to realize it. This is the expected result of studying Vedas and Vedangas. The expected result of studying Vedas and Vedangas is that he should know the purpose of life. He should know that he has to go to the Guru for that purpose. And he should know that he has to renounce everything to get that purpose. So, after getting his mother's permission, we are not entering into the details. After getting his mother's permission, he walked from that Kaladi village in Kerala, crossing hills and dales and forests and rivers to reach Omkareshwar at the bank of Narmada, because he had understood in his heart that his guru, the teacher, Govindapad, lives there in Omkareshwar. And there is a shloka from the mantra from the Mundaka Upanishad. Parikshalokan karma chitan brahmano nirveda mayat nasti akruta krutena kim syat. I am not describing the whole thing. Tad vigyan artham sa guru meva vigachet samit panim shrotriyam brahmanishtam. So the real purpose of studying Vedas and Vedangas is that I must go to a guru and learn from him and realize God. That is the one method. That is the one result expected. We can move it from the other side. Suppose we get this result, we need not study Vedas and Vedangas. Or in the modern world, we'll say, if we methodically study Sri Ramakrishna Leela Prasanga and Swami Ekanda's complete verse, this is what happens in our heart. This is what happens in our heart, that we must go to a guru. And the only purpose of life is to realize God. This is what happens by methodically studying Sri Ramakrishna, the great master, and Swami Ekanda's complete works. So, or you may say the four yogas. No. Swami Ekanda's complete works and Sri Ramakrishna, the great master, you may add, if you like, the gospel of Sri Ramakrishna. This comes as the net result. So, result by studying Vedas and Vedanga should be this. Otherwise, studying of Vedas and Vedanga is of no use. Or they are not being studied methodically. And if without that we can achieve this, then there is no need to study. Or the modern interpretation of Vedas and Vedanga is that the Rishi Vakyas, those who have experienced Brahman in their life, their teachings we should study. And if we study their teachings, we are inspired and guided to go to God. So, in this way, this definition of Adhikari, we should split into process and the result expected. And the process can be either defined in the modern terms or the real result of the process is this. If without that process we are achieving this, fine. So, what is the result? Apatato adhigata akhila vedartha. Apatato means superficially. Apatato means at a sight. Adhigata, he has assimilated akhila vedartha, the meaning of the entire Veda. And what is the meaning of the entire Vedas? To go to the Guru and realize God. And so, that is how the Adhikari is being defined. First factor. Second factor, Asmin Janmani Janmantareva Kamya Nishiddha Varjana Purasaram. So, in this life or in some past life, we shall see why it is not like that. Having already rejected works which are born out of desires and works which have been prohibited, works which give desired results, also works which we get undesired results. So work with results. Varjana Purasaram. Purasaram means throwing them at the back, we are proceeding. And something we have done. Nitya, Naimittika, Prayaschitta, Upasana, Anushtana. Anushtana is having practice. There are some works. Sananda will go on telling details, but as given the names, you must understand. There are some words called Nitya Karma, must be done every day. Naimittika, but there is a variation. On important days, something else has to be done. We will not do the Nitya Karma on that day. Example, Sri Ramakrishna's birthday. No, on that day we are not doing our Nitya Karma. We are doing some other work. So, they are also important. Naimittika means due to some special occasion. We have to do those things. Prayaschitta. In our life, we do commit mistakes. And then say, sorry, I will not do again, is not sufficient. Because the mind has been prone to do that mistake. And every possibility is that there you will repeat that mistake. So what our Shastras have prescribed is that you must punish yourself for any mistake done by you. There is an incident in Swamekanda's life, though we do not find it in the standard biographies, but there is an incident. When he was a small boy, some mistake he committed. And the moment he understood that he has committed that mistake, there was that tawa, you know, the iron plate on which rotis are baked. It was there on the chula oven. He went and sat there for a moment to punish himself so that the mind will never go there again. So then the mind will never go there again. So these prayaschittas have to be done. Because we are prone to commit mistakes. When we understand a mistake, the repentive work has to be done. And upasana. Some form of thinking of God, some form of putting our mind on God must be practiced. Otherwise, we do not get the mood of absorption. The Vedantic realization requires concentration of the mind, absorption in a particular idea, and this happens only when we practice upasana. Upasana literally means sitting near. That means thinking of God in some way or the other. So, nitya, naimittika, prayaschitta, and upasana having practiced. What is the result? Anushthanena nirgata nikila kalmashataya. All the dross in the mind will be removed. We left one clause deliberately because the place is here in the syntax. We see some people like Swami Ekanda, like Sri Ramakrishna's disciple, like Nachiketa, like Jnaneshwar. They don't seem to have practiced this Nitya Karma. They don't have to practice Naimittika, Prayaschitta, or Upasana. How they are fit? For that the reply is, Asmin Janmani Janmantareva. Because the life is a continuity. If something we have achieved, spiritual, if some spiritual thing we have achieved in this life, it is never lost. We start from there in the next life. The example I will give, but I wanted to give two examples for Veda Vedanga study. The other is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's elder brother Vishwambar. The moment he completed his studies, he left the home, became a sannyasi, and went in search of God. So that is the expected result of studying. the Vedic literature. Now in the modern times, it is only the education which Yahweh concerns. Now if somebody is there without any education, is awakened, fine. But otherwise, education, real education, awakens us, and we see all the Ramakrishna Mission sadhus. Having completed the education, they come. So that is the second example was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's elder brother. Several examples are there. Now, next point I was telling was that in many cases, few cases, of course, we see that they are not doing as expected, nitya karmas, namitya karmas and all that. And they are fit to realize Brahman. How that has happened? They have done it in their past lives. So, asmin janmani janmantareva. The syntax is here at this point. Kaminishita varjana purasaram is all right. For this nitya namityaka prashita upasana, they have done in their past life. Or kama nishita varjana, they already done in their past life. They are not doing again. Now they are doing nitya namityaka. So we should not be baffled by seeing that some people proceed directly. We should not be baffled. I'll give some examples. Sri Ramakrishna's disciple, Akhandananji, Turiyananji, apparently small children, but they're behaving like the old people, taking three times Ganges bath and eating avishya and all that. So some people asked Sri Ramakrishna why they are doing like that, like old people. Sri Ramakrishna said, you are seeing them young in this life. You do not know what they already crossed in their past life. So, these spiritual achievements of the past life are not lost. So, we need not be baffled that some people, you are telling that you must do nitya karma. See, these people are not doing, they are fit people. So, that is explained by telling that they have completed in their past life. So, asmin janmani in this life, or janmantareva, or in some other life, they have completed kama nishiddha varjana purasaram nitya naimittika prayaschitta upasana anushtanena pradhapan nirgata nikhila kalmashataya. That means in the process, in the process in which all the dross of the mind is being removed or has been removed. Nirgatam is gone away, nikilam is total, kalmasham is dross. In this process, by this method. Nitanta nirmala swanta. So the swanta means antakkaran, the inner organ, consisting of man, buddhi, chitta, ahankar, generally summed up as mind or chitta. So it is called chitta shuddhi or purification of the mind. Nitanta nirmala, absolutely pure it has become. Now here one more important point I'll tell. This adhikari is not a stage. It is the direction of life. Shankara has clearly explained this in Athata Brahma Jigyasa. It is a continuity of something. That means there is a misunderstanding that only let us be fit adhikari first. Then we will come to Vedanta. That is not correct. When the life has taken this direction, then we should come to Vedanta. So, Vedanta is undertaken when the direction of life is in this particular direction. And so, this is the meaning of Nitanta Nirmala Swanta. Absolutely pure. Who is absolutely pure? Sri Ramakrishna was sitting and Totapuri came and looking at Sri Ramakrishna, he said, you appear to me to be the Uttam Adhikari of Vedanta. Will you undertake Vedanta? So who is Uttam Adhikari? Who does not require Vedanta? Who is a perfect man? Who has already reached perfection? And the very word Uttam Adhikari shows there are Madhyam Adhikaris, Manda Adhikaris. So this Adhikari is a gradation. The life must take this turn. Then only we are fit to come to Vedanta. So Nitanta Nirmala Santa should be taken in this idea, with this idea. And when he becomes pure, what does he do? Whatever he thinks as conducive to realization, he starts himself. So sadhana chatushtaya sampanna. Four means of knowledge he undertakes. He has completed sampanna means this should be taken as a gradation. And the sadhana will tell later on, but we can understand sadhana chatushtaya, viveka, vairagya, shamadhi shat sampatti and mumukshutva. Shakti will become nine. Because shamadhi shat sampatti, six are included as one. Discrimination, renunciation or dispassion, mental control, physical control, not allowing the mind to go outside, forbearance, leaving faith in the scriptures, and practice of putting mind in God. This is called Shat Sampatti. And Mumuksha is the result. Or all these are undertaken only when there is a keen desire to be free. Feeling of bondage is the meaning here. All these we'll see through Sadanandaiti again and again, but we are seeing this preliminary way. And Mumuksha, so this all results into the keen desire to realize God. This is called sadhana chatushtaya sampanna. Pramata. This makes a man able to measure God. This makes a man able to realize God. So he becomes the realizer. Adhikari tu pramata. Adhikari is that who can realize God. He has made himself ready in this particular way. So, after dividing this into the way and the result expected, we have seen the real meaning of Adhikari will be one who is of pure mind, one who is keen to realize God, one who is practicing whatever is conducive to realize God. That is the Adhikari. Means that if life is such, he will benefit from the study of Vedanta, otherwise he will not. So, we proceed. He takes up one by one word from this, that is his type. So, adhikari tu vidivat adhita veda vedangatvena, all right. Apata tu adhikata akhila vedartha, all right. Asmin janmani janmantareva, all right. Kamya nishitta varjana purasaram. So he takes up what is this kamya karma, what is this nishitta karma, that he takes up to define. There are some works. The motive behind those works is some fulfillment of some desire. And such works must be given up. We should not undertake any work which we are prompted by the desire. So it defines kamyani, swargadi ishta sadhanani, jyotishtomadini, ishta sadhanani. Ishta means desired result, those which will accomplish desired result, ishta sadhanani, swargadi. Future life glorious, future life happy, future life full of enjoyment, that is called swarga. The root meaning of swarga is suvarga, a nicer place, a nicer state of life. The swarga can be in this land itself. From a poverty, if a man becomes rich enough, he is Swarga. From not being educated, if educated, he is like Swarga. These days, where is the Swarga, you know? America. Everybody struggles to go to West, to go to America. So these desired objects, the work leading to desired objects are shunned. No. I want to realize God. What shall I do by going to America? Anyway, I don't want to dilate on this, but you understand what I am telling. Ishta Adi. Adi means any enjoyment in this life or hereafter. Sadhanani. Jyotishthoma was one of the Vedic sacrifices expected to lead us to heaven. Adini. So, one example he has given, but he means that any work done with the expectation of the fulfillment of some desire, they have to be shunned. Nishidhani. In Veda, there are some forbidden work, don't do, because you will go to Naraka, you will go to hell. Though in Vedas, hell is very rarely mentioned, if at all. But the lower birth is supposed to be like hell. Instead of man, you will become animal. Instead of man, you will become insect. Instead of man, you will become reptile. If you do proscribed works, so that is called Nishiddha. Nishiddhani, Narakadi, Anishta Sadhanani. So general concept of Naraka as used here, going down. That is what they will give you. Brahmana Hananadini, this is an old idea. Or we have to change the meaning of the word Brahmin. We have to take the real meaning of the word Brahmin. If Brahmana Hanana is a papa, is Kshatriya Hanana not a papa? Is Vaishya Hanana not a papa? Is Shudra Hanana not a papa? So killing somebody unnecessarily is proscribed. So Sanandayati writes in 14th century. We must understand it in the modern terms. So, Brahmana Hanana Adini, he has given the scope there. Just for some gain, you are killing a Brahmin. You will go to hell. You will definitely go to hell. You will definitely have to be born as a lower animal. So, Nishiddhani means proscribed works which take you down. For example, killing a Brahmin. Killing any man unnecessarily. In war they kill. In war they don't see Brahmin or Kshatriya. Dronacharya had joined Kauravas. So he had to be killed though he was a Brahmin. So it is not the caste which decides. The real meaning of the word Brahmin, note down who want to. Manusmriti quotation I'm giving. Janmana jayate shudra. Sanskara dvija uchyate. Veda pathi bhaved vipra. Brahma janati brahmana. By birth a man is shudra. Uncultured. Sanskara dvija uchyate. When he goes to educate himself through that upanayan sanskar by going to a university or a school, then this is called dvija. Though all these words are generally used for a Brahmin, but the real meaning is this. Dvija means twice born. Once born bodily, second time the cultured mind is being born through education. So that is dvija. Veda Pati Bhaved Vipra. When he has finished his studies, he is called the Vipra. Vipra is another name for Brahmin. But Vipra means one who has finished his studies. Brahma Janati Brahmana, one who knows Brahman only is called a Brahmin. Of course, here Brahmana Hananadini, you should take in the most general sense, and that also is an example. Now drinking wine, so many adultery, they are prescribed good, which evidently will bring bad results. So one should never go that side. काम्य निषिद्ध वर्जन पुरस्सर. सो नाउ कम द पॉइंट, व्हाट आर द नित्य कर्मस, एंड दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. नित्यानि अकरणे प्रत्यवाय साधनानि संध्या वंदना दीनी. What are nitya karmas? They are not expected to give any result. Though one who performs nitya karmas is bound to go to heaven, bound to get good results, but normally they are not do such thing for such result, that is not given. But if you do not do it, you will incur sin. A karane pratyavaya sadhanani. If you do not do, you will incur sin. Now, before proceeding, let us logically ask. If you do good thing, you will get good result. If you do bad thing, you will get bad result. Not doing something, how it will give you any result? Not doing something, how will you get any result? So, this has a psychological explanation. Logically, you cannot explain this. And with examples, I will quote. Your duty is to work in the office or study or whatever is your nitya karma. And the cricket TV starts. And you throw away your work and go to that. Harm will come to you. So this holding steadfast to the appointed work is very important. Sometimes, friendship, what is friendship? Let us go somewhere, no? I will give a more terrible example. Something from our Ramakrishna Mission. Mahapuruji was in Bhuvaneshwar. And one of his attendants had the duty to prepare breakfast and give it to him. Luchis, in you know Bengali, luchis, maida, puri is prepared out of maida, is called luchis. He had to fry luchis and give to Mahapurush Maharaj. Now every day, the luchis were getting a little burnt, overbaked. But one day, they became too much burnt. So this man felt a little sorry and told Mahapuruji, Maharaj, today the luchis are burnt. Mahapuruji said, nothing will happen if luchis are burnt, but I see your forehead is burning. You know the meaning? Why the luchis were burnt? This sadhu had developed illicit relation with a woman. And so the mind was diverted there. And in a few days the result came. That woman became pregnant and the sadhu had to run away. So akarane pratyavaya has to be psychologically understood. You are not doing nitya karma, you are expected to do, you are not doing. It means your mind has gone elsewhere. Otherwise, how not doing will produce any result? So, I have given you a dire example. But in our life, I have given you so many examples. Cricket, this, that. Something happens. People run away there, leaving their duties. So, nitya karma, not expected to give you some result, but they have to be done because not doing them will lead to bad result. Akarane pratyavaya means sin, pap, wrong result. Pratyavaya sadhanani, they accrue bad results for you if you do not do them. Example, sandhya vandana didi. What is sandhya vandana? I don't want to take names. But recently I heard, sitting in a taxi or in a car, somebody's car, he had put up a discourse from one of our Swamis. If you do pranayam in the evening, it is Sandhya Vandana. If you do it is Sandhya Vandana, not at all. Not at all. Sandhya Vandana means not the Vandana for Sandhya. What is Sandhya and what is Vandana? What is Sandhya? In the night, we have Tamogun generally. In the daytime, there is Rajogun. At the dawn, the meeting point of night and day, it is Sattogun. Evening, meeting point between day and night, it is Sattogun. Also, in the mid-noon, when the sun is at the zenith, then there is a null point, Sattogun. And for yogis, midnight also is Sattogun. So this joining of day to night or night to day is called Sandhya, Sandhi, joining. At that time, if you do not think of God, when shall you think? So, Vandana means Vandana of God. Vandana means thinking of God. Vandana means some methodical chanting of Gayatri Mantra. But Gayatri Mantra is not independently chanted. Some side things are there, do that, and then chant Gayatri Mantra. That whole process is called Sandhya Vandana. So worship of God done at the point of meeting point between day and night is called Sandhya Vandana. Adini has said, but this is the most important Nitya Karma. There were traditions. Boys and girls were playing in the afternoon. As soon as there was sunset, they had to wash their hands and feet, sit quietly and think of God in some way. Some stotras, something, Hanuman Chalisa or Sandhya Vandana actually means repetition of Gayatri. That is for the Brahmins and others. But thinking of God, contemplating God some with some method at the point of juncture between day and night is called Sandhya Vandana. And that is given as the most brilliant example of Nitya Karmas. I wanted to tell a little story here. When I was in Mumbai in the Ramakrishna Mission, I was finding it very difficult to find evening. Because of the electric lighting and all that, these days it has become very difficult to find the joining point between day and night. One day, one lady came to me and asked me, can I meditate in the midnight? I understood two things, that she can meditate. But then, why are you asking me this question? She said, I have heard that devils are at work in midnight, so they may catch you. I said, madam, you have heard half the truth, which is untruth. If you remain awake in the night and do not do something, then the devils will catch you. But if you are awake in the night and meditate, the rishis will help you. Anyway, the lady was satisfied. I thought that God has sent this message to me. I am not finding this Sandhya here. Can I not get up after a little sleep and think of God in the midnight? So, Sandhya Vandana is this. And this is the most brilliant of Nitya Karma. Other things are appointed duties are to be done. That is called Nitya Karma. Niyata Karma, appointed duties have to be done in their proper time. Most important being thinking of God in the morning and evening, etc. So we study one after the other definitions. Suddenly it is brilliant definitions where we want to differ because of the time. It is the 14th century, now we are in the 21st century. So certain things do change and we shall think of that. Certain things we will see in the broadest way, and though we'll follow this faithfully. So we read up to sentence 9 today. Sentence are counted. Sentence 9 were read. Om Akhandam Satchidanandam Avan Manasa Gocharam Atmanam Akhiladharam Akraye Bhishta Siddhaye Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat Shri Ramakrishna Arpanamastu.